TSmiley. So TSmiley was a component with a component designer, property editor built by Nick Hodges. And you can search for TSmiley, T-S-M-I-L-E-Y, on the internet. And you'll find some articles. In particular, you might find an article written by Nick, TSmiley 2010, The Next Generation and Uselessness. And along the way, he goes and posts links using the Wayback Machine, the Internet Archive, going back to some early articles that he did. This one back in, TSmiley dates back to beta test time. But he's got some articles here about using Delphi and talking about VBX controls. But the great things in Delphi is that you could build controls, build a component, build a component editor, property editor. And so Nick did that as a way of learning about components. He created his TSmiley, set the different fields to start in the constructor. And he had a property called mood, M-O-O-D. And so he had a property mood, which had reader and writer for reading the field and then setting the mood. And he had an enumeration for the different smiley moods. So SM sad, SM happy, and so on. He had events so that you could do things. He had a property editor for the T-mood property. And he registered that property editor, so you call register property editor, and then some other information about how to construct components, set the mood, and so on. How to register the component so that it would show up in the component palette. There's this like funny press release kind of thing that was Data Monterey. Nick was at the Naval Postgraduate School at the time, and so he put out this press release in 1995. In May. Today, SmileyWare Systems Incorporated announced the release of their newest venture, Delphi Component Building, the TSmiley component. We feel that this component will really revolutionize the way people think and feel about Delphi programming and their computers in general, says Nick Hodges, Chief Design Engineer for TSmiley. We worked long and hard at SmileyWare to meet our customer needs and to produce a product that does what it set out to do. We feel it will fill a large hole in the Delphi environment. It's a native Delphi component, completely written in Delphi. And then he's got some comments and quotes about TSmiley. Here's me. Oh, boy. A truly useless component. Pamela Hodges. Why would anyone want that? His wife. Let's see. His daughter, Goo Goo Gaga. And then Dr. Bob said a TSmiley a day keeps the doctor away. I'm not sure if that was the medical doctor or Dr. Bob.
Probably
both.
Yeah.
And then an update along the way when we had 32-bit versions. So there was a 32-bit version of TSmiley that Nick then updated in 2010. And again, he talks about updating it. Let's see, he put it on CompuServe, and then we found out about it and started using it in our demos. Actually, we'd not only do TSmiley, but T-Multi-Smiley. We'd put a bunch of smileys on a form and then use a timer event to change the mood randomly of all the smileys. So you had all these smileys running around. So that was like the ultimate in multiple mood and multiple personalities. Here's a quote here. The usefulness of TSmiley cannot be measured. That says it all, I think. Now, it came out of a discussion as well about could someone build a truly useless component? You know, and it turns out for me that TSmiley actually wasn't useless because you could use it as a glanceable interface. For example, how your build's doing. Oh, it's going to be happy. Or the stock market. How's your stock doing? Oh, yeah, it's not good. You're going to be really sad. You know, or stock market's closed for now. Maybe you're in some other way. So is it a useless component? I don't know. You be the judge. It's on SourceForge. You can download it. So you can search on SourceForge for TSmiley, and there's a zip file to download it. And so here, let me switch to my IDE, make sure this is coming up. There's in the zip file, there's a project group. There's three parts in the project group. It's called Smiley Group. There's the package file, the BPL, and it contains some graphic bitmaps, It's got the DCR, and it's got this unit for that implements the Smiley. So if we look at this Smiley, TSmiley is a class that inherits from T graphic control. It's got mood strings and mood descriptions. That's always a good thing. Here's the enumeration. Let me go to my layout called Max Code. So here's SM happy, sad, shades, tongue, indifferent, ooh, frazzled, and so on. And then he's got strings for this. He's got the property mood with the reader and writer. So reading the field, F mood, and calling set mood to set. And then here's the constructor. So he sets a default. Well, I guess Smiley should be happy. So he sets a TSM Smiley for the start. And then he's got a destructor, and he's got a mood change. He's got to get the bitmap from the resource, get a description for the mood. That's a string statement. And then a few other things, set bitmap, a paint method to draw the canvas of the Smiley face, and so on. So that's pretty cool. Get the hint, set the hint, set the mood. So, you know, traditional stuff. Toggling between Smiley as you click on it so that you can go between the high and low of the enumeration. Toggling, incrementing the Smiley mood along the way. He's got, here's the register of the component. You register the component. He used the custom string, and then an array of whatever components you want. You put those in the square brackets. And if you have any property or component editors, you can register those as well. In this case, the property editor, you pass the type info for the component and the name of the property itself that you're going to modify. And that shows up then in the IDE. He's got this chooser dialog box, which has the Smiley type and description that gets loaded. And he's got an image list for all the bitmaps of the components that gets built up. And you might want to use that in your app. Here's a sample app that has a panel up here, and he's going to create a Smiley. I put one on there so we could play around at design time with the mood and bring up the property editor. He's got application events, so you can do hover hint. This is some other work. You can toggle in this sample, and it just goes and calls the toggle method in the component. If you have a Smiley, meaning it's not null, he's got a... on one of the button clicks, the first one, if there is a Smiley, he'll free it up. Otherwise, he'll create a Smiley and center it inside of the panel that it's container, and set its parent to the panel, and then enable the button 2 and button 3 if he's got a Smiley. And again, one of those is toggle, one is choose the dialog box, and then on form close, call free. The user interface, again, of this application is these buttons, and the Smiley is going to show up in the panel. So let's go back to a default layout. So here in the panel, it's just a traditional panel. So if I choose the Smiley, you'll see the mood. Here's the mood here. And since it's got property editor, we can click on this. And here's the chooser, which is all of the different types of Smileys that are currently defined in this version of TSmiley. So happy, and then a description that'll show up and that'll get loaded into the label here. So that's pretty cool. Out, cold, frazzled, oh, indifferent, and so on. I guess others you could extend the Smiley in addition. And we can go and change that one to maybe indifferent, for example. Okay, and then on the button, we'll just do that. So let's, what I've done is I've built the runtime package, and I've built the design time package here, and I just right mouse click, you can do build, and then you can do install. And so when I'm in the user interface down here in the custom palette, there's TSmiley inside of my IDE. So I drop one of those down, and then I can compile and run the application, create a TSmiley there. It's now centered in the panel. I can toggle it. I can choose, you know, from the dialog, a different Smiley. And so on. And then when I close, it's there. So there is the TSmiley component with a property editor.
Very cool.
With bitmaps and so on. I haven't tried this in 64-bit Windows, but I guess there's always that. I could build 64-bit versions of the package. of the package file and build a 64-bit version. This was based on Delphi 2010, which didn't have 64-bit. I don't know if I should try it or not. There's always that chance.
Go ahead and try that. I want to remember see if I can get okay. Alan if he's ready for
he's going to do that. So let's just change the platform. Let's add a 64-bit platform, and let's go and build that version. Oh, there's an error. It looks like, design ID not found. Okay. So something changed along the way in 64-bit land. Okay. Let's try doing this. And add platform. I think this is going to fail as well because I don't think he deployed it. Yeah, we can't find the other version for 64-bit land. But that was a little about TSmiley. And again, you can go to SourceForge and download TSmiley, and it's there. I think SourceForge was having some issues. They're doing some maintenance, and it's in static mode.